Yeah, I watched that. I watched musicals, Guys and Dolls. I'd never seen it before.
Okay.
Ever see that one?
No, I never did see Guys and Dolls.
Okay.
Opinions?
Well, you know, I'm not a musical guy, but I thought I'd give it a shot. I tweeted about this.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the first half of the movie, the gamblers are up in arms because they've got to pay $1,000 overhead to, you know, for the place where they're going to play their floating crap game, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they're trying to get the money together to get the overhead for this gambling operation. Then in the second half of the movie, they convene in a sewer. And it's the most spacious, well-lit sewer you've ever seen. There's dance numbers that go on. That's where Luck Be a Lady breaks out, and they're all dancing around. It's in a sewer. Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking, like, well, wasn't the sewer available before the day before when you couldn't get the money for the other spot?
Mm-hmm.
It just didn't make sense to me, logically.
Luck be a sewer tonight. And how is old Blue Eyes? How is he? Is he, does he just capture, does he grab the screen?
He's all right. You know, he wanted the lead part. He was mad. You know, you get those little info commercials at the end of the movie.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it turns out, yeah, he was mad that Marlon Brando got the main part and they didn't hit it off. They were fighting through the whole production.
Speaking of fighting, that's somebody I would love to have fought once. Sinatra.
Oh, Sinatra.
Sinatra. Well,
he's a lightweight.
He's a lightweight. I'd knock his block off.
Oh, yeah. You kill him.
Any era. L.A. is My Lady when he's wearing that dumb members-only jacket.
Any era. Uh-huh.
Remember when he wore a members-only jacket on the cover of L.A. is My Lady? It's like... People at Members Only must have just been like, "Uh-oh, our product is now represents old hoodlums." Because he was a hoodlum, he was a cheap hood.
Yeah.
Sinatra, a bully. He'd go to a casino. I remember he went when Atlantic City opened. He went to the casino and he started yelling like these slurs at the dealer because they wouldn't like let him win. What are you not letting me win? Yeah, no, we're not letting you win.
It's called gambling.
Yeah, it's called gambling, you dope.
He's a you know what they call a wannabe in Bayonne? A tomato gangster.
A tomato gangster. He was a tomato gangster. He's just the guy who watches somebody else beat someone up and then is the guy who yells, like, you got knocked the bleep out. Like, that's who he is, basically. He's just like a high-class version of that kind of guy. Yeah. What a blight. He's a blight on the... Hoboken should scrub any trace of him from there.
Well, yeah, he turned his back on them. Yeah, well, I don't know why they keep honoring him. Yeah.
He made it, and then he's like, oh, I'm never coming back here.
Yeah.
Well, good. Don't come back. Take your lousy music with you.
How many songs does he have about Hoboken or New Jersey? None.
Hoboken, taking a tour of Kearney. Gonna swing by Hohokus. Stuck outside the Lincoln Tunnel.
Lamb Broth House.
Lyndhurst.
Maxwell's.
Yeah. Going over to Maxwell's. Todophonic Todd, get me a nice table in the back. That sucks. He sucks. Frank Sinatra, awful. Cheap hoodlum. Bully.
Thug.
Well, I wouldn't call anybody a thug, Pat. That's a hurtful.
Wow, Pat.
Can you believe this guy called Frank Sinatra a thug? Guy. Can't believe it. Sure, he's a bully.
Read that article, Tom. Frank Sinatra has a cold.
By Gay Talese.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the start of, for a lot of people, that's a benchmark in new journalism.
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Do you ever read that, Pat?
I was screening a call. What'd you say?
There's an article called, there's a magazine article. I think it was maybe for Esquire. Yes.
Yeah.
Where the reporter, Gay Talese, the writer, was supposed to have an interview with Frank Sinatra. And the article, he couldn't get the access to him. Like, he was promised it, then it gets taken away. That's right. That's the gist of it, right? I haven't read it in a long time, but it just... So he writes about the experience of not getting access to Frank Sinatra. And it's called Frank Sinatra Has a Cold. And it's really amazing and kind of changes the game in terms of a lot of writing in that regard. To write about the experience of the writer and not just do a generic puff piece. So I like it. But Sinatra, and I would love to have gone toe to toe with that guy. Take his dumb members only jacket off, hand it to one of his guys. Like, yeah, you should take your members only jacket off if you don't want blood all over it. That's what I'd say to him. The only thing he did that I like is that song Future. You know that song?
I don't know.
Is that from his Trilogy or something?
From the Trilogy, yes.
I never heard that.
He did this album called Trilogy, where it was like one album is past. One is present, and the craziest one you've ever heard is called Future. And basically, it's this dope is singing about space travel. Let's pull up Future. Let's see. Trilogy, past, present, and future. And like the songs he does on it are like, he does something on it by the Beatles, and he introduces it as like when he did it live, he was like, this is a song, a new classic from Lennon and McCartney, something by the Beatles. And then he does, it's like, it's by George Harrison, you dope. Dummy. Uh-huh. I gotta find where's the, let's see.
My name is Francis Albert.
Francis Albert Sinatra.
That's the craziest thing you've ever heard right there.
Nuts.
19 seconds in. My name is Francis Albert. Francis Albert Sinatra.
And I sing love songs, mostly after dark, mostly in saloons. I've had some...
Saloons. Give me a break with that saloon nonsense. I'm just a crooner in a saloon. No, you're not. You're playing the Forum.
Do you think that he had heard these songs before going into the studio, or he just went in there fresh, looked at the lyrics, and just sang?
I think he knew them. He was just this artistically deficient that he and just racked by egotism that he couldn't tell the difference about what he couldn't read the moment.
Very good year. I haven't missed a whole lot in those firecracker years, and I don't want to miss a thing.
This sucks. Where does he get into space?
By the window where I can see all those marvelous things to be seen out there.
bass yet.
What time does the next miracle leave? Let's get this show on the road. And when the satellite tours begin, count me in, count me in.
So this, he would have been one of these dummies who goes on these space journeys. He would have been up there with Shatner. He would have been in the Shatner seat. So it's a song, where, when's the next miracle leave? It's about him going into space. "2001, A Space Odyssey. Going on the moon, gonna see the object. The
when I arrive at Venus, it will surely be spring."
Just let that sink in for a second. When I arrive on Venus, it will surely be spring.
Is this like one continuous track, the side of an album?
Mike, this song is 10 minutes long.
Oh, 10 minutes, okay.
So he's going to space.
"And the girl I have waited for will be waiting for me.
Some green chick waiting for old Francis Albert to show up on Venus. Hey, baby, pour me a 7 and 7. You spilled the rum on my shirt. Back on the spaceship.
And she'll dance with me all the afternoon. Comfort me when the darkness falls. And she'll still be there in the morning. When I need her the most. Maybe when I get to Venus, I will never be lonely. Dry. Jupiter won't stay fat, so Jupiter leaves his faucets on, and that is that."
We went from Venus to Jupiter. Where next?
"Next stop, Pluto, where the devil dwells."
"Pluto is a rotten place, an evil misbegotten place. It's Hades.
It's Hades.
Filled with graduates of the pen, a sordid flock of criminal men, and ladies.
Ladies.
Ladies, ladies, ladies.
It's pure hell when your journey ends there. But you can bet your ass I'll need a lot of friends there."
Any thoughts from the crew here?
My God.
Bet your ass.
Yeah.
I never thought I'd hear him sing "bet your ass."
No. He's also going, wait, hold on.
"We will lead us out to Neptune and his deep blue."
So what is he going from Venus to Jupiter to Mercury to like
to Neptune?
They're he's out of order, right? With these planets.
Yeah.
"Next thing we do, set the controls for the heart of the sun. We're going right at the middle of that flaming ball. Shooby dooby doo. Pilot the ship right at the sun.
You see.
It's like he's having a psychotic break.
Can I read a fact from the Wikipedia page on this?
Please do.
On his WNE,
you're reading it out loud. I thought you just wanted to read.
Oh no, I can read it offline. Don't worry, I'll just do that.
Okay. Okay.
On his WNEU AM show, Jonathan Schwartz described the future suite that forms the final part of this album as narcissistic and a shocking embarrassment. Sinatra rang to complain and had Schwartz suspended from his job.
Class act. He's classy. Mr. Sinatra was a class act. Get him out of here. He said a mean thing to me. He said a mean thing about the weirdest record ever recorded.
Nobody calls me a narcissist.
Yeah. You call me a narcissist, I'm going to have you fired for saying a bad word about me. Now am I a narcissist?
Actually, sir, that's textbook narcissist.
Yeah, exactly.
You're fired.
It's 101. A cheap thug. I guess, Pat, you're right. Thug did fit. I apologize.
Full circle.
Full circle. Circle of life, just like Pumbaa from... what you call it? Lion King, right? Well, look. If I could go anywhere in time, I would go fight Frank Sinatra. That'd be a good one. Uh-huh. I'd ask him, yeah, you see, yeah, you saw the planets. Now you're going to see some stars, right? Now you're going to see some stars when I knock your bleeping block off. Watch him beat me with one punch.
Look at his bodyguard on you.
Yeah, he would probably send one of his bodyguards on me. But you know what I'd do then? Karate chop him. Judo chop. Uh-huh. Judo chop, just like Roger Moore. Judo chop. And then there was that thing when Dean Martin and Sammy Davis Jr. were in like the Cannonball Run movies. And then he's like, why won't you let me in one of these cannonball things? And then he shoots a scene for Cannonball Run 2 where he doesn't even get out of the car. Like a limo pulls up and he like talks through the window, I think. Uh-huh. Sinatra, you bum. He's a disgrace. These are the biggest disgrace. This is what we should do as an episode. Top 20 biggest disgraces from New Jersey.
Oh, really? Right? I think that's great.
Because yeah. You'd have Sinatra. You'd have...
John List?
John List, yes. You'd have John List. You'd have...
Southside Johnny.
You'd have Jared Kushner.
Oh, I didn't even know he was from New Jersey.
Yeah, he's Jersey, right?
I don't know. Joe Piscopo.
Joe Piscopo. Look, this one's going to be very easy to do. We just got to make sure
we're halfway through it already.
Make sure somebody make sure Gethard didn't do anything like this on his network, his New Jersey based programming. But we got something. We'll show them a little bit about New Jersey too, huh, guys? So, yeah. Francis Albert Sinatra.
Should we do a Sinatra bio for the next book club?
Old Toilet. That's what they called him, Old Toilet. His nickname was Old Blue Eyes, and then they changed it to Old Toilet. Should we do a Sinatra what now?
Biography.
No, we should not.